Say you have a data that you want to reuse but only need to tweak the value slightly. Duplicating your prefab not only is harder to track but is also prone to a lot of errors. Luckily, Unity has a system that you can use. Enter Scriptable Objects. It is a system that allows you to create and customize reusable data containers and is primarily used to store and manage game-related info such as settings, configs, and asset references. It can also be used to create data sets for things such as monster stats, item inventory, and any reusable information, just to name a few. Scriptable Objects can be created and modified within the Unity editor and provide a convenient way to organize and share data across different game systems and components. By utilizing this system, you can create modular and scalable game architectures, enhance code reusability, and streamline iterative processes within your project. In this video, you will learn to set up scriptable objects, apply this system into a sample dataset, and I'll throw in some professional industry practices, so make sure you watch this video all the way to the end. And with that, let's script some objects. Inside Unity, I made a sample use case where you may want to use scriptable objects. In this window, you have the item icon, its name, description, and its market value. The item icon also has a masking component so the image does not bleed over the background. Create a script, open it up in your code editor. Delete the start and update methods as it is not required. Change the mono behavior and use scriptable object instead. Add the fields for your item sprite and item name. For the item description, I also added a text area attribute for it to be more friendly in the editor later on. It has a minimum and maximum number of lines before it uses a scroll wheel to view the remainder of the text. Lastly, I added the item cost field to finish our scriptable object script. Back in Unity, we have no prior way of creating data in our newly created scriptable object. If you select it, you will see that the item sprite has a sprite field but the rest of the fields we created are yet to be used. To fix this, go back to your script and add in a create asset menu attribute. The file name is its default name upon creation, while the menu name will be the location where you can find and create the scriptable object data. Do note that you can also add in a subfolder by adding a slash by the end of each word. Now, if you right click in the project folder and select create, you will see the menu item we have just created. Click on it and it should create the scriptable object. Name the scriptable object as you see fit. Afterwards, all that's left is putting in the information and you now successfully implemented your first scriptable object. One good trick that I learned is to duplicate an existing data and modify its values instead of creating a fresh batch every time. This will save you time and the references attached to it will be your starting point, similar to a template. The next step will be using its data into our dataset. Select the game object and add in a script component. Inside the script, I removed the update method and left the start method alone as we will be using it for setting our data. I added in our item scriptable object and used serialized field to modify its contents in the editor while keeping it private so that the other scripts wouldn't affect it in the future. I then created a debug line so I can see if the scriptable object is working. As you can see, it auto-completes the values we have set previously. Back in our scene, drag the scriptable object you created in the item field. Once you click on play, you will see the information has been successfully extracted. Alternatively, you can also create a method in the scriptable object script and call it that way instead. It's now time to connect our script into our window. Add the Unity Engine UI and TM Pro namespaces. Next, create the item image field followed by the item name, description, and cost text mesh pro GUI fields. Set its contents by connecting the fields found in your scriptable object like this. For the item cost, add the toString at the end to convert its in property into a string. Back in Unity, connect the references into the empty fields. Once you run the game, you will see it fully functional and ready to go. This is what it looks like for the other one we have set earlier. Thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next one.